Dinner and a Movie is brought to you by Hamilton Walkers.
Well, there are so many movies on various streaming platforms, and here to point out some of those overlooked gems that you can find on Netflix are film critics Pam Powell and Chuck Koplinski joining me in the Weather Garden. Hey, guys.
Hi, how are you?
I'm great. I'm thinking it's been like, what, almost 6 months that we've all been together in the same space?
It is. It's 6 months almost exactly, so it's great to be back here to see you guys. Well, at least to see you, Heather.
Well, I'm hoping that these movies are worth you guys actually coming to the station to talk about. We're going to start with you.
All right. We are going to start with The Polka King, which is available on Netflix. This is something that, from 2017 that I think really went under the radar. Stars Jack Black as Jan Lewin. And he's a very sweet man who has this little tchotchke shop in rural Pennsylvania. And he also has an obsession with polka music and polka dancing. To feed that obsession, though, he needs money, and that tchotchke shop is just not going to give him enough money to do so. So he begins to scam old people out of their money. It begins to be a Ponzi scheme, but he's so sweet and so nice about it that nobody really cares and nobody really understands what's happening until the FBI gets involved. This is funny from the very beginning to the very end. And we also have Jackie Weaver, who plays his mother-in-law, who is like a junkyard bulldog. She is something else, and she adds so much humor to this. A lot of fun, 95 minutes long, and I think, Chuck, you'll love that aspect. I think you love this movie as well. So check it out on Netflix. Funny, based on a true story, a documentary. Jack Black is hysterical.
Oh, I love it when they're based on a true story.
Yes.
So you can really connect with the people. Okay, Safety Not Guaranteed.
Safety Not Guaranteed is not based on a true story. And this is one of those little hidden indie gems from back in 2012, I think it is. Mark Duplass stars as Kenneth, and he believes that he can build a time machine to travel back in time. So he places an ad, a classified ad, in the newspaper. Three writers get a hold of this ad and think this is going to make a great story for a magazine, and they travel out. Aubrey Plaza plays one of the lead characters along with Jake Johnson and another cohort. They end up getting entangled in Kenneth's whole situation and his rationale and his paranoia until what's real and what's not and what's believable. This is a really bittersweet, fun story that I really think takes chances in the indie film world, and I think you'll really enjoy it, and that too is available on Netflix.
And it said it was from the producers of Little Miss Sunshine, who I know Chuck was a big fan of.
Love that movie.
So, okay, your choices. We're going to start with an education.
Yes, two more that are hidden on Netflix, and things get hidden on Netflix really easily because there's so much. This one's from 2008. It stars one of my favorite actresses, Carey Mulligan. Takes place in London in the late 1960s. She's a suburban girl. She's in high school. Got the whole world in front of her, and she falls for an older guy played by Peter Sarsgaard, a guy who's almost double her age. He seems to have the world on a string. He seems to have a very good job. He's very educated. He's very sophisticated, but, well, there's something more to this guy, and there's something that we don't really want to know about. The education isn't what she finds out in school. It's what she finds out in the school of hard knocks as she goes through a very tumultuous time with this guy. Just a charming film, funny, touching. You can't go wrong with this one. Really, really enjoyed it.
Okay, what about A Ghost Story?
A Ghost Story. A Ghost Story, this is not what you think of from the title. It's not a horror film by any stretch, but it does feature a ghost. The ghost is played by Casey Affleck, and we see him early in the movie, married to his wife, played by Rooney Mara. A horrible accident occurs, and he ends up dying. Well, he can't leave her. He can't go on to the next level, the next afterworld, wherever it might be. So he decides to hang around. And he actually puts a sheet over his head and he watches her. He watches her to make sure she's okay. He watches her to see how she's going on with her life. And, well, it takes a while before he decides that he can move on. I found this, and I'm not making a pun, but I did find it very haunting, and a film that really stuck with me long after I watched it. It's very romantic, but in a very, very subtle way.
Well, these are four movies that I was not familiar with, but I will say I appreciate you bringing Netflix to the table here, because when I get on Netflix, it takes me as long to watch a movie as it does to find the movie, and so that's always frustrating.
Yep.
Good. I'm glad we could help you out.
All right. Hey, if you want to see all of Chuck and Pam's movie reviews, whether it's in theaters or streaming. You definitely need to check out their website, Real Talk with Chuck and Pam, and we'll have that at CILiving.tv. We're so glad y'all are back.
It's great to be back, Heather.